Well, it was our experts told us about London. And can you tell me what's the name of London's dialect? How they speak English?
Cockney.
Yes, it is Cockney. Okay, and the weird picture of Cockney has described in his celebrated play George Bernard Shaw. And now our actors and actresses will show you two small extracts from the play. Okay, let us start. happening.
Would you like to go any of it again?
No. Thank you, not now. I'm quite enough for this morning.
To listen to sounds?
Yes, it's a fearful strain. I frenzy myself that I can pronounce 24 distinct sounds, but your 130 beat me. I can't tell the difference between most of them.
Oh, so it comes to strength. You hear no difference, of course, but you keep on listening, and presently you find they are all as different as A from B. What's the matter?
A young woman wants to see you, sir.
A young woman? What does she want?
Well, sir, she says she'll be glad to see you here when you know what she's come about. She's a very calm girl, very intent. I hope you listen to her.
Oh, that's all right. Yes. Has she an interesting accent?
Oh, something dreadful, sir, really. I don't know what is interesting in it.
Let's have her. Show her out, Mrs. Pierce. This is where there's a bit of luck. I'll show you how my crack is. Let's have her talking, and I'll take it down first in Belle's visible speech, then in oratory, and then we'll get her on the phone with her so that you can turn her on as often as you like with a written transcript before you.
Oh, this is a young woman.
Why, this is the girl I just got last night. She's no use. I've got all the records I want from the little girl window. And I'm not going to waste another scene in the whole field. Be off with you. I don't want you.
Don't you be so saucy. You ain't got what I got for you. Did you help to remember the next scene?
Nonsense, girl. What do you think about gentlemen like Mr. Higgins?
Oh, we are proud. He ain't above giving lessons, not he. I heard him say so. Well, I'm not asking for here to ask for any compliment, and if my mind is not good enough, I will go elsewhere.
Good enough for what?
Good enough for you. Now you know, don't you? I come here to have a lesson, and I'm ready to pay. No mistake.
Well, what do you expect me to say to you?
Well, if you was a gentleman, you might ask me to sit down and see. Don't you tell your agreement in your business?
Shall we ask this baggage to sit down, or shall we throw her out of the window?
Oh, and what we call the baggage when I offer to pay like any lady?
What do you want, my girl?
I want to be a lady in a flower shop, instead of selling at the corner of the Tottenham Court Road. But they won't take me unless I can talk more gentle. He said he would teach me. Well, here I'm ready to pay him, not asking for any favor, and he'd raise me if I was a dirt.
Oh, how can you be such a foolish girl?
Why shouldn't I? I know what lessons cost as well as you do, and I'm ready to pay.
How much?
Now you are talking. I thought you'd come with me. You saw Chance and Big Jack me last night. You hadn't drunk, hadn't you?
Sit down.
Oh, if you're going to make a compliment to me.
Sit down.
Sit down, toss your toe.
Ow!
Will you please to sit down?
Don't mind if I do.
What's your name?
Lisa Doolittle.
Eliza, Elizabeth, Betsy and Bess, they went to the wood to get the bird's nest.
They found a nest with four eggs in it.
They took one a piece and a three in it.
Oh, don't be silly. You must speak to the gentleman like that.
Well, why are you extensible to me?
Come back to business. How much do you propose to pay me for the lessons?
Oh, I know that's right. A little friend of mine gets French lessons for 8 pence an hour. A real friend, gentlemen. So I won't give more than a shilling. Take it or leave it.
You know, Piccadilly, if you consider a shilling, not as a simple shilling, but as a percentage of this girl's income, it works out as fully equivalent to 60 or 70 guineas.
How so?
Figure it out. A millionaire has about £150 a day. She earns about half a crown.
Who told you I only?
She gives me 2/5 of her day's income for a lesson. 2/5 of her day's income would be somewhere about £60. My judge is enormous. The biggest offer I ever had.
£60? What are you talking about? I never offered you £60. Where would I get?
Hold your tongue.
But I ain't got £60.
Don't cry, silly girl. Sit down. Nobody's going to touch your money.
Somebody's going to touch you with a broomstick if you don't stop stealing.
Oh, I want to see my father.
If I decide to teach her, I'll be worse in 2 hours to you. Here.
What's this for?
To wipe your eyes. To wipe any part of your face that feels fun. Remember, that's your handkerchief. And that's your sleeve. Don't make no mistake if you wish to become a lady in the shop.
It's no use to talk to her like that, Mr. Higgins. She doesn't understand you. She doesn't understand you. She don't.
Here, give me the handkerchief. Give it to me, not to you.
He did. I think it can be regarded as your property, Mrs. Pierce.
Oh, so you're right, Mr. Higgins.
Higgins, I'm interested. What about the Ambassador's Garden? I'll say that you are the greatest teacher alive, if you can do it. And I bet all the expenses of the experiment, you can't do it, and I'll pay for the lessons.
Oh, you are really good. Thank you, Captain.
It's almost irresistible. She's so deliciously low, so hard and dirty.
Ah, I ain't dirty. I've washed my hands and face before I come. I did.
And you certainly are not going to taunt your head with flattery, Higgins.
Oh, don't say that, sir. This more ways than one of turning hand to girls. But nobody do better than Mr. Higgins.
What is life of the series of inspired fools? The difficulty is to find them to do. Never lose a chance. It doesn't come every day. I shall make a duchess of this draggle-tailed goddess night.
Ow!
Yes, in 6 months. In 3, she has a good dog, her the quick time. I'll take her anywhere and pass her off as anything. We'll start today, now, this moment. Take her away, please, Mrs. Pierce. Monkey bread, if it won't come off any other way. Is there a good fire in the kitchen?
I'd like to see Clara and her mother come here, please. Clara and her mother, your applause, please. It's right for you. Well, next, Brandy and a butterfly. Mrs. Higgins and Higgins. And two, Eliza Doolittle. Well, thank you very much. I'm Nikolai Yurich. Thank you.